In the field of video generation, what is the problem that bothers everyone the most? I believe many people would say speed. Today, we are going to teach you about a super video acceleration model. It can increase video generation speed by 200 times. Yes, you heard that right. It can be increased by 200 times. This technology is called Turbo Diffusion. Here is a video I generated during my actual testing using the WAN 2.2 image to video model at 720p resolution. On average, how long did it take to generate each of these videos? About 40 seconds. This is the amazing change that the Turbo Diffusion model brings to us. What you see now is the Turbo Diffusion page on GitHub. In the initial information, there is a clear statement that on RTX 5090 graphics card, generating a video can achieve a 100 to 200 times speedup. In the section below, we can see many examples. For instance, with the WAN 2.2 image to video 720p model, the generation speed is about 38 seconds. Without this model, it might take over 4,500 seconds. How effective is it really? Let's take a look at whether the generation speed is truly that fast. First, you need to install and deploy the environment. You can choose a cloud server or a local server. I am using a cloud server here. You can use 40 series and 50 series graphics cards. Since the official tests were conducted on a 5090, I hope you also choose a 5090 if conditions allow. Depending on the server you deploy, the specific tools and storage directories used later might vary, so adjust according to your situation. Let's click on JupyterLab. After entering this page, notice the file manager is on the left. First, switch to the root directory in the file manager. I have provided a command notebook here. When you open it, you can see some commands I used during testing. You can use them directly to generate the corresponding videos. The models are all placed in the checkpoint folder. Currently, I am providing the WAN 2.1 480p model and the WAN 2.2 720p model, as I feel testing other models isn't very meaningful right now. On the starting page, we can open a new terminal. You need to confirm your current virtual environment, which should be Python 3.12. Your current working directory might vary, so I suggest you adjust it yourself. We can use cd to enter the root directory, then the workspace, and then the downloaded Turbo Diffusion directory. Now, the left and right sides are in the same directory. All our commands must be executed within this directory. Next, let's do a test. There is a very important command we need to run in advance, setting an environment variable. If you don't run this, generating a video will result in an error. Our commands have two parts. One is the command for WAN 2.2 text-to-video T2 volts. Let's see how to use this basic command. I have a list of detailed parameters for this model here. Since this is a Python program, we use the Python interpreter to run it, then we specify the model. Since I am using a WAN 2.114b model, I can write it like this and specify the model's location. As mentioned, they are in the checkpoint folder. I am using a quantized version, so the generation will be faster. My resolution is 480p 832 times 480 or 480 times 832. Below is the prompt, which must be enclosed in double quotes. Further down is our sampling steps. We use 4 steps. Because I am using a quantized model, 4 steps are sufficient. We also specify the aspect ratio. I am setting it to landscape here. The last part is the save iPath, which is where the video will be saved. Let's copy this command in our terminal. After confirming the environment and directory, paste it and press enter. It will enter the model loading phase, starting with the T5 encoder clip. Then the main model, once the main model is loaded, it loads the VAE, which is also very fast. Look at the generation speed. It took only 15 seconds. This is amazing. Now, let's check the output in the output folder. We can find the video of a beautiful woman walking on the streets of Tokyo. The effect is quite good. Next, let's look at changing the resolution. I've set the aspect ratio to 916 for a portrait view and used a Chinese prompt. However, the character doesn't look Eastern. I think this was an issue overlooked during model fine-tuning. If I specify a Hanfu beauty, it should be an Eastern character. Let's change the prompt to Chinese Hanfu beauty. Now the character traits are clear, showing a distinct Eastern beauty. Actually, the biggest advantage of this model doesn't lie in its performance on WAN 2.1. Let's look at the WAN 2.2 model here. I am providing an image to video model, specifically the 720p version. Look at the first command. I have also listed some of its parameters here, but be careful, some are not applicable. For example, the aspect ratio. Because this is image to video, your aspect ratio is determined by your input image. Therefore, you cannot specify an aspect ratio in this command. We use Python to execute this command. The model type is a WAN 2.2 14B model. Since it's a WAN 2.2 model, we have two parts, a low noise model and a high noise model. We use a reference image here, which is the first one we saw. Below is the prompt, and further down are the sampling steps and the final saved file name. Let's paste and execute it directly. Most importantly, let's look at the time used for sampling. The sampling is now complete, and we used about 45 seconds. This is extremely fast. Let's look at the generated effect and get a feel for it. It is actually fantastic, including the clarity and the character's performance. The consistency of the movement is beyond reproach. I have generated many vertical test videos, and as you can see, the overall quality is very high. Finally, let's check the horizontal performance. I have an image here of an elf beauty, and we will use it to generate a video. The sampling is complete. You can see we still took about 40 seconds. This is also very beautiful and has no issues. Of course, using traditional prompts might still result in situations where there isn't enough dynamic movement. You might consider using JSON formatted prompts. However, be aware that when using JSON prompts, because our prompt option must be enclosed in double quotes, the quotes inside the JSON must include escape characters so they can be recognized normally. Let's look at the effect. You can see that the JSON format provides relatively more dynamic movement, including facial expressions and body actions. Lastly, let's talk about its installation. First, pay attention to the basic environment. The PyTorch version it uses is 2.8.0. Therefore, we suggest the CUDA version you use is 12.8. This is why we run it on a 5090 card, as 12.8 is compatible with the 5090. Similarly, we are using Python 3.12. Moving on, we need to install the Turbo Diffusion main program. There are two installation methods. One is using pip install, and the second is compiling from source. I recommend you just use the standard installation. Also, note that even if you use pip to install Turbo Diffusion, you still need to clone this repository because the programs we need are all inside. For example, where the models are downloaded is based on this base directory. It's just that we don't use this directory to install Turbo Diffusion itself. The reason this model is so fast is that it uses a special attention mechanism. Therefore, we need to install that first. Just use this command to install it. Further down is the model download. There's a link for each model here. Once you open it, there are two models available for download, a quantized version and a non-quantized version. Generally, we choose the quantized version for faster speed. If you install this program yourself, these are the general steps. The difficult part is actually setting up your basic framework correctly. If the basic framework doesn't match, many subsequent installation steps might not be able to proceed. Through all these tests, you have likely noticed that this is indeed a super acceleration model. The speed is increased by nearly 200 times, yet the video generation quality has not significantly decreased. All right, that's all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.